The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 4, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on March 24, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Aparam bhavatu janma, param janma vivasyata, tathameta vijaniya, tamado prutvaniti. Arjun knew it perfectly well that Krishna, his friend, is the Supreme Personality of God. But to clarify the matter for others, because those who are not devotees, they cannot understand Krishna or Bhagavad Gita. That you have explained in the previous verse, Krishna said that the subject matter of Bhagavad Gita is a great mystery, rahasyam. But because you are my devotee and because you are my friend, therefore, I am again speaking to you the same yoga system which was long, long millions of years ago I spoke to the sun god. Imam vivasyate yogam pratyavan aham abhayam. It is lost now, sakalena yoga nashta parantapa, because the parampara system has been diverted or misused, therefore it is now lost. But still, I shall again repeat the same yoga system, which is very, very old, Purana. Although I spoke it first to Vibhushan, the sun god. Vibhushan is the present sun god, or the president, just like you have got the president in your country. The Americans, they have got their president. Similarly, each and every planet has got its president. The present president is called Vibhushan. Of course, their duration of life is very, very great, greater than ours. But still, they are also human beings. They are also living beings, having a different type of body. They can live in that sun planet, although it is fiery. That I have already explained. The children must not talk. So Arjuna knew it perfectly well. Because there are foolish men like me, they cannot understand that Krishna spoke this Bhagavad Gita millions of years ago to the sun god. We immediately say these are all stories. But it is not story, it is fact. Therefore, Krishna, to clarify the matter, Arjuna, to clarify matter to the fools like us, is asking this question, that, my dear Krishna, we are contemporary, as I am born some years ago, you are also born some years ago. We are cousin brothers. So how can I believe that you spoke this science or the yoga system of Bhagavad Gita to the sun god? Suppose if I say, just now I am coming from sun planet, and I talk to his son God, will you believe me? When he's talking nonsense, he's coming from sun planet. So, this is possible to inquire by the layman, because people understand Krishna is like us. Abhajananti man mūḍha manuśintanu māsutam param bhāvam ajānam. We accept Krishna, general people, Sometimes we do not accept. There are many so-called scholars. They say that there was no Krishna. It is all fictitious. There was no battlefield of Kurukshetra. It is all fictitious. They imagine their own meaning. But that is not the fact. Krishna is also historical. At the same time, he is the Supreme Personality of God. These things cannot be understood unless one is a devotee. Therefore, in the previous verse, it has been said, Bhaktosi. The mystery of Bhagavad Gita can be opened, disclosed to the devotees, not to the non-devotees. The non-devotees may speculate in their specific platform of activities as politician or as mundane philosopher or mundane scientist, but that is not the fact. The fact should be learned from the devotees of Krishna. Therefore, we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is, and it is being accepted all over the world. We have the greatest sale of our edition, this Bhagavad Gita. Just 3 months before, I got report in London, in 2 months, we sold about 30,000 copies. And the trades manager of Macmillan Company, he has sent me later that while the other editions, they are diminishing, this edition is increasing by sale. Why? Because it is presented as it is, without any wrong interpretation. People are appreciating. This is a fact. So, people do not believe that Krishna is a historical person, at the same time he is the Supreme Personality of God. They think that he is many learned man or a great politician or a beautiful man like that. Abhajananti manu mungha manusim tanumasita param bhava majan. They do not understand the background of Krishna. So this thing is being clarified by the question of Arjuna. Aparang bhavato janma. You are born along with me, you are my contemporary. And paramjanma vivasata, and the sun god or the president of the sun, Mr. Vivasa, he is long, long ago. How can I believe that you talked with him? This is the question. Aparam bhavato janma, paramjanma vivasata, katham etat vijanya. How I shall believe it? Yes. This is possible to inquire like that. Tamadu Puraktavan, iti, you first of all spoke this. This is the difference between God and the living entity. God does not forget, we forget. This answer will be in the next verse. Bahuni me batitani, janmani tavacha arjuna. Tani aham bheda, sarvani. I understand, I know everything. In another place Krishna that I know the past, present, future. That is knowledge. Knowledge means, perfect knowledge means past, present and future. There are many foretelling in the Srimad Bhagavatam about this Kali Yuga. They are stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Means future. Srimad Bhagavatam was written 5,000 years ago. Still, what was stated at that time, they are coming to be true. That is called Shastra. Past, present and future. So Krishna knows everything. Vedaham samiti tani. He says that I know everything. Past, present and future. That is perfect knowledge. Why you are hankering after Krishna? Because he is perfect. We are not perfect. We have got so many deficiencies. We commit mistakes. We are illusion. We cheat. and our senses are imperfect. We cannot acquire knowledge by sense perception perfectly. So with so many imperfectness, if we try to become a teacher, then I am a cheater, I am not a teacher. We must know first of all. So we are receiving knowledge from Krishna, because Krishna is accepted the Supreme Personality of Godhead and perfection of knowledge. So here the matter is being clarified and Krishna is answering also that bahuni me janmani vatitan. Krishna, yes, Krishna says jada jada hi dharma sabdani bhavati bharata tada atmanam sijamaham. He comes on this planet or in this universe. When he comes in this universe, he comes on this planet. There are innumerable universes, not one, but innumerable. So there is a rotation of Krishna's coming here. Just like the sun rotates every 24 hours, he is visible in the morning. Just like here, just now it is 8:30. At 6 o'clock in the morning, the sun will be visible. Everyone can say, any experienced man, this is not foretelling by experience. Any child can say that tomorrow at 6 o'clock the sun will appear. Similarly, the Shastra says, at certain such time Krishna will come. One who knows, one who does not know how he'll say. But there are indications in Brahma's one day Krishna appears on the Dapur Yuga. So therefore Krishna says, bahuni me janmani, bahuni me batitani janmani tavacha Arjuna. He have also passed many births, and I have also many times appeared. And because we are friends, we appear together, that is also fair. But the difficulty is, tani ahanga veda, I know all those things. When I appeared last, what did I do, and when I shall again appear, these things known to me, tani ahanga veda. Sarvani, sarvani, past, present and future, I know everything. Natu natanga vetha parantapa, although you are a great warrior, parantapa. Parantapa means one who can get and one can give trouble to the enemies. Paramatapati. So, although you are a very great warrior, a great personality, but you cannot know this. You cannot know. That is the difference between you and me. That is the difference between God and the living entity. We had our past life, because Dehantara Prati, we have changed our body, and we shall change this body also. After annihilation of this body, Vasansi Jinnani Yatha Vihaya, old garments, old cloth, when it is too old, unusable, then we give it up. We accept another new cloth. Similarly, when this body becomes unusable, then we change our body. We get another new body. This is the way of transmigration of the soul. This is a fact. Dehinasmin yatha dehi kaumara jovanam jala tatha dehantara prati dhirasattva namayati. So dehantara prati is there. But we have forgotten what I was in my last life. That I cannot say. Neither I can say what kind of body I am going to get next. That I cannot say. Our knowledge is so imperfect that we cannot say. But Krishna can say, past, present and future. It is said here. Tani ahanga veda sarvani. Everything. Sarvani means I veda, sarvani means past, present and future. Now we can derive conclusion that how is that? Krishna appears like human being and we are also human beings, the same two hands, two legs, one head. How is that he knows everything and I do not know? The conclusion should be derived like this, that we forget because we change our body. Just like I was a child, you were a child, every one of us. We did so many things in our childhood, but we have forgotten. With the change of the body, the activities of my past body is forgotten. This is a fact. Similarly, when we change this body, we get another body, we forget. But why Krishna has not forgotten? That means he does not change his body. This should be the conclusion. This should be the conclusion from right logical point of view. I forget because I change my body. Krishna does not forget, he does not change his body. This should be the conclusion. And Krishna says also that sambhavami atmamayaya, I appear and disappear by my own energy. We are forced by the other energy. Just like I have got human body now. Now I shall have to change my body after my death. That change of body is not in my hand. Actually it is in my hand. Because according to karma, if I work nicely, then we get good body. And if we do not work nicely, then we get bad body. That is, we can understand from this shastra. Urdhanga chanti sattva spa. How we can understand? Shastra chakkhushyat. You have to see through this shastra. Otherwise you have no eyes to see past, present, future. Just as astrology. Astrology, by calculation, through the shastra, the astrological calculation can say what you were in your past life and what you will become in your next life. That is the astrological system. they can say like that. through the shastra, by that calculation, we can understand. So, what is that? The total is Urdhanga Gacchanti Sattasva, those who are situated in the modes of goodness, Brahminical qualification. Sattva, Sama, Dama, Titikha, Arjava, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Astitvam, Brahma, Karma, Sabhava. If we remain perfectly Brahmin, truthful, clean, Sattvam, Saucham, Sama, sense controlling, mind controlling, Sattvam, Samsav, Samam, Dhamam, Titikha, tolerance, Arjava, simplicity, Jnanam, full knowledge, Vijnanam, application of knowledge in life, Vijnanam, Astikam, full knowledge of the Absolute Truth, Astikam, Brahma, Karma, Salam. If we remain in this qualification, Brahminical qualification, this is called Sattvastha, situated in the Satogon. The Rajogon and Tamogon cannot conquer. In that situation, you will be elevated to the higher planets. This is Shastra says. Urdhanga chanti sattasva, madhe tishthanti rajasa, and the middle planetary system. This earthly planet is the middle. Bhur, bhuva, sa, atru, sargulo. If we remain in the modes of passion, then within these planets we may rotate. And javanna guna vittishta adhogacchanti tamasa. Those who are tamasa, because they have got very abominable characters. The abominable character is described in this shastra, sinful life, illicit sex, intoxication, meat eating and gambling. These are the four pillars of abominable life. Tamasi. The shastra says, tamasi ma jyotirgam. If we remain in this tamasi, then javanna guna vittistha adhogacchanti tamasa. Adhogacchanti means lower planetary system or animal life, degraded life, abominable life, low-grade life, we serve them. This is the samansa. But we do not know, although do not know, but the nature's law will oblige me to accept the body. Like that. Karmana daivana trena janta deha upapatti. We get another body according to the karma we are performing now. So, Arjuna is a devotee. That has been explained in the previous. Bhaktosi. Bhaktosi me sakha sethi. Arjuna is not only a devotee, not ordinary devotee, but personal friend. Arjuna is personal friend of Krishna. Bhaktosi sakha sethi. Therefore, Krishna says, tani bahuni me batitani janmani tabachar. You are my bhakta and personal friend. So whenever I appear, you also appear with me. Because he is bhakta. Bhakta and Bhagavan, they must be together. That is the advantage of bhakta. Although he has got the frailty, because living entity is the minute particle of God, mamaivaamsa jiva-bhusha. Therefore, his intelligence, his power is also very minute. But God's power is unlimited. By unlimited power, Krishna knows the past, future, and present, everything perfectly. But our limited knowledge, we cannot know that. Therefore, we have to receive knowledge from Krishna. This is our position. Tad-vijñānārtham sa gurumeva vigacchet samitpāni subhutinam brahmanishtham. So we have to approach either Krishna or Krishna's representative. Then we can understand Krishna. Otherwise, simply by mental speculation, by so-called erudite scholarship, nobody can know. Panthāstu kūti satavatsa sampragamya vāyurathāpi manaso munipungavāna sapvastija prapadasīna avichinta tatte govindamādipulisam tamāngana. Even just like you go by aeroplane, this is air speed, there is another speed. Panthāstu kūti satavat sampraga vāyurathāpi manaso munipunga. There is another speed, mind speed. We have experience of the light speed, of the air speed, but we do not know what is the mind speed. Mind speed is so strong that within a second you can go many millions of miles, within a second. And you can understand if the mind speed is so strong, how much the speed of spirit is so strong. Krishna says, in the Bhagavad Gita, tatta deham punarjanma naiti mami iti kauntiya. If you become fully conversant with Krishna consciousness, the result will be tatta deham, just giving up this body, just immediately after this. Tatta deham punarjanma naiti mami iti. Others, those who are not Krishna conscious, they will accept another material body. Immediately they will have to enter into the womb of a mother, particular mother, daivana trena. As soon as decision is made by superior power, that living entity has done certain such things, he should be promoted or degraded, he should enter into such mother's body through the semina of the father. So immediately he is given place in the material body of a mother. But those who are Krishna conscious, immediately they are transferred with Krishna in them. This is the process. Immediately, by spiritual force, tatta deham punarjanma naiti mame kaunte. Mame, immediately comes to me. Krishna is there. Within this material world, he is also there. In some of the universes, there are innumerable universes, I have already explained. Somewhere he is there. So, a devotee, just after giving this body, giving up this body, immediately is transferred to that universe where Krishna is there. And when he is trained up, then he, again, is transferred to the Goloka Vrindavan, the spiritual star. These are the description of Sanatana Goswami in Bihup Bhagavatamrita. how a living it is. So, in this way, we are changing our body. But because we are minute particle of Krishna, we have got qualities of Krishna, not 10%, 78%. When that perfect, so minute quantity, then we can also become a little more advanced than at the present moment, but not like Krishna. Krishna is 10% perfect. We can become minutely perfect, 78%. These are all analyzed by the Goswami. So, in the present state, our conditioned state, there is no comparison with Krishna. What to speak of becoming Krishna? The rascal, foolish persons, they claim that they have become Krishna. It is not possible. This is the defect, that we forget. They ask the soul, so many incarnations of God, about his past life. They cannot speak. So this is the qualification of God. He knows past, present and future. And those are false gods. They cannot say. That is not possible. This is the test. They are claiming, falsely claiming. But God means He knows. His body does not change. But He knows past, present, future means His body does not change. Why He does not change? That is described in this heart. Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. Vigraha means body. Form. This transcendental form is made of Satchit Ananda. Satchit Ananda. Sat means eternity. Om Tat Sat. So, Satchit. Chit means full of knowledge. Full of knowledge, yes. Tani Aham Veda. Sarvani. This is called Chit. He knows everything. Past, present and future. Satchit and Ananda. You see Krishna's form here. Ananda, he's enjoying. This is real Krishna's form. He's always enjoying. Anandamaya Vyasar. In the Vedanta Sutra, it is said. The Anandamaya. Krishna's real form, the Krishna's form in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, that is not Krishna's real form. That is Krishna's Vasudeva form. Krishna expands Vasudeva Sankarsana Anuruddha in that way. So, this is a great science, Krishna science. If you are interested, there are books you can study and you can understand what is Krishna. Thank you very much.